I know what y'all thinking. Y'all probably thinking, will we ever see Mutt gameplay from Launchpad again this year? Well, guess what? You will. I know you guys probably thinking after that situation when my disc got stuck, y'all probably thinking like, man, we never gonna see Mutt again, but this team is practically from the ground up that I just built here. No money spent. I haven't spent any money on any of these cards or nothing like that. Just been grinding the solo challenges for a little while now. That's why I haven't been posting many videos. Plus, I'm on vacation at the same time. So, you know, my wife is getting her, like, you know, PhD thing or whatever. So, you know, while she's getting that, I've been here grinding at the solo challenges. And look at this team. We got an 84 overall team. I have played some games, so I can tell you guys about the cards. So hard to tell you guys about the cards if I haven't played any games. But let's get started with the lineup update. You know, right from the gate, we got Phillip Rivers here. Let's click on it. 70 speed, 94 throw short, 92 throw mid, and 86 throw deep. This guy, 95 awareness. I didn't even realize that. 90 throw power. This card is beastly. He makes all the throws. There's not a throw that he can't make. And truthfully, that's really all I need. He has 70 speed. I wish that was a little bit higher, but it's Phillip Rivers. You know, who are we kidding here? I did play with the Cam Newton in my solo challenges. As you see, he has no more life left. So, but I did play with him, and he was pretty good. He's not as good as Drew Brees. I mean, not Drew Brees. I'm sorry, Phillip Rivers, as far as throwing the ball or Tony Romo, in my opinion, the 82 overall Tony Romo. To me, if I had to rank these, I would rank Phillip Rivers number one, of course, which should be the case. He's a 90 overall. Tony Romo, he's just a better passer to me, in my opinion. Cam Newton, and then this Cam Newton, if I had to rank. I've been playing with all four of them. So if I had to rank them, and you're curious about that ranking, that's the ranking right there. Let's move on. Let's go to the running backs. We got Jamaal Charles here at the helm, 86 overall. 89 speed, 93 agility, 89 acceleration, 86 carry, 93 ball carry vision, 92 juke, 91 elusiveness. I'm going to be honest with you. This Jamaal Charles doesn't feel as elusive as I would like it to be versus this David Johnson, who has 8 ticks left. This David Johnson, when he gets the ball, he's just crazy. For some reason, I mean, not crazy. He's not like over elusiveness, but he's to the point where I feel like if I give it to him at the goal line, it's like an 85 to 87% chance that he's going to score that touchdown if I give it to him at goal line. So I might just start incorporating that more in my game as I'm playing the game. This Giovanni Bernard is a beast. Remember I had him on the Xbox One version. You know, when I was playing Madden on the Xbox One before my disc got stuck. he's a beast. He just does everything. I don't know if there's a better 81 overall card in the game besides that one. Marcus Allen. I actually got this from a Doritos bag. So yeah, that's probably the only money I spent outside of, you know, buying the game for the PS4. Him and I got an 80 overall Von Miller eating some Doritos. So yeah, this card, it's in my opinion, it's a beast. At times, at like, let's say you ran like 6 plays of Marcus Allen. One of those plays, he's gonna do something amazing. I don't know what the thing, you don't know which one it is, but them other 5 plays, he's gonna be average. But you know, not bad here. You know, I'm not sure why David Johnson feels better when I run with him versus Jamaal Charles, even though Jamaal Charles is a better card and his stats are, I'm not gonna say superior, but they are better. So he has 10 ticks better in elusiveness. David Johnson got him in the carry by 1. They got the same speed, agility. Jamaal Charles has him by 8. Ball carry vision, Jamaal Charles has him by 3. Juke move, Jamaal Charles has him by 3. So I'm not quite sure as to why David Johnson feels better when I run with him. I don't know. I do got the boy Darren McFadden. As far as kickoff return, he's okay at that, just in case you was curious. Move right along to the wide receivers. At number one wide receiver, we got my man DeAndre Hopkins, man. A beastly card right here. It definitely put in work. catches just about, he drops some passes though, but he catches mostly everything. I say there's about an 85% chance that he's going to catch the ball. And for my number one receiver and me starting off the way I'm starting off, you know, no money spent and just kind of doing it from the helm, a lot of these cards I got was for the cheap. Even this Ryan Tannehill, 87 overall, very cheap, out of position. You guys know I love to have at least like one out of position player. And who better than to have a quarterback at wide receiver, Tannehill, 6'4". He catches just about everything, to be honest. He catches more balls than DeAndre Hopkins does. I'm not sure why that is, because Ryan's catching traffic is at 86 versus DeAndre Hopkins 90. DeAndre Hopkins only has, DeAndre Hopkins has one tick better than him as far as actually catching the ball. So I'm not really sure as to why I don't know why Ryan Tannehill catches more passes. He's actually my slot receiver, believe it or not. But my second receiver on the right-hand side is Alshon Jeffries. He catches just about everything, 90 catch, 90, catching traffic, 85 speed. That speed definitely shows, the 85 speed. But there are times where I feel like he has an 87 speed, if that makes sense. 92 releases, really, really nice and deadly, to be honest, man. You can definitely tell that his release is better than all my other wide receivers when you watch the game. Just pay attention very closely to the games. I did have Keegan Allen as my third wide receiver. But ever since I got this Ryan Tannehill, he's been taking over, man. And he's an absolute beast. The rest of these receivers really don't get a lot of play. for real. Probably with the exception of Tavon Austin on punt returns. But Moncrief does show up often for me in that salary cap. I will admit that, just in case you was curious. Moving right along. They only got 735 coins. You know I'm broke. Jimmy Graham is basically the only tight end that really matters on his team as of now. I think I paid $2,000 for him when I got this card. This is one I actually had a while ago when I first started playing on the PS4. So I just kind of just kept him. I will definitely upgrade my tight end when I get a chance or an opportunity. Pitta is actually the second tight end on my team. I'm not sure why he's over Julius Thomas. I don't know, but he catches the ball well. So, you know, until he starts, I don't throw to my second tight end that often. You know what I mean? And his run block is decent. You know, until he starts slacking, he's going to be there for a minute. Like I said, until I get better tight ends. My offensive line, not bad, but not great. This guy right here, a little disclaimer here, Ryan, whatever his last name is, you guys know I'm not too good with pronouncing them long, difficult last name. You got to know how I roll as far as that. But he's not going to be in the gameplay that you're going to see early. You're going to see him in this season coming up, but like late in the season, like the fifth or sixth game of the season. So definitely look out for him. He's a pretty good blocker. I picked him because he had 90 pass block. It's very important to me. Pass blocking is my favorite thing about offensive line. This is my offensive line. Not really nothing special really to say about it, except for what I said about but this guy is kind of a beast too in his own right, though. For an 81 overall card, he's pretty beast. Let's go to the defense. Right up the middle, man. Right up the gut. My boy CJ Mosley. Woo! This guy is a beast, man. I actually was playing with this Von Miller for a while, and I didn't really, with the exception of him coming off the edge every now and then, and I think kind of shocking the quarterback, kind of shocking my opponent every once in the blue, I really didn't get a good feel for how this card works. I'm a little upset about that, because I usually have a good general idea of how cards work and what I like about them. But, you know, it is what it is. He was a 90 overall, actually, believe it or not. Well, I guess he's 85 because he's on the, this is the middle linebacker version. But anyway, CJ Mosley is a beast, man, 6'2". You know, can kind of catch like a wide receiver at times, man, batting down balls. 71 zone, but that don't even matter because I'm running around with him most of the time anyway. So his zone kind of really doesn't matter. 85 speed is important. 90 tackles important. 91 pursuit important. 86 awareness important. 86 hit power important. He's a beast. That's really all I got to say. He's a beast. This card right here, I believe it's Rob Ninkovich. Hopefully I said that correctly. If I botched his name, I apologize. And I hate to botch people's names. But what I really noticed about this guy in particular it's his awareness. I'm not sure what it is, but he just always seems to have a knack for being around the ball and just making, being at the right place at the right time. Even in coverage, sometimes he's the one out there covering some of the receivers, and he's like neck for neck with him sometimes. I'm like, what the heck? But the only thing about him covering receivers is that he doesn't get his hand up. So sometimes his covering receiver is almost pointless to a degree. But being though he's right there, what is good about it is that being though that he's right there, what's good about it is that, you know, he makes my opponent be like, man, I can't throw there because, you know, he's there. So that does help. Paul Kruger. I'm not really sure. I'm not really sure what I see. This car is not spectacular, but he's good for right now. He's good for right now. 74 speed, 84 tackle. It says 84 tackle, but I don't think I've ever seen him miss a tackle. I'm kind of going off the top here. Why I don't have the boy Alden Smith over him, I'm not really sure as why I don't have him over him. I might switch that, but I got to be honest, Paul Kruger has been working fine. You know, he's been doing just fine. So he'll probably stay there until he makes a huge mistake, I guess, or his deficiencies are too much for me to handle. Then I'll switch him out. But until that just hasn't happened. He's just been very sound, to be honest. Free safety. We got Malcolm Jenkins. Probably the only person on my team that forces fumbles. I'm not really sure why. I don't ask me why that is, because he only has a 76 hit power. You know, 76 is kind of a lot, but, you know, it's not 80s or 90s. But for some strange reason, he's the only one on my team that can make people fumble for some strange reason. Really good zone coverage at 89 overall. You know, 6 feet, that's a decent height. Actually, it's pretty really good height. 83 speed. Feels like 93 at times. I mean, he's just he's a very sound player. I can't wait to get him upgraded, but he's very, very sound. I will definitely say that. I mean, definitely someone I'm delighted to have on this roster. Calvin Pryor III. I mean, this is a guy, he hits hard. He's the one player when I do the hit stick, I know it's going to come out the way I want it to come out. But the only problem with him is that he doesn't make people fumble. I mean, I'm not going to say that's a problem, but as you can see, we had the Cam Chancellor earlier. I use it mostly in solo challenges. So you won't be getting any Cam Chancellor 85 overall gameplay. I'm sorry about that. I use them in the solo challenges. But for the sake of this video, this guy was getting, ethered a little bit. I'll be on the sides with y'all, man. He was getting ethered. I'm like, come on, Cam. I know it's 85 overall Cam Chancellor, but you're talking about versus a computer. So I'm not really sure how he would have fared, and it would have been interesting to see though versus an opponent. But you know, I was still in that groove where I was trying to, you know, stack up on coins. Just keep in mind that a lot of these players I have are very, very cheap. Let's keep that in mind. Here goes some other cards that's behind the defense. In case you guys was wondering a little bit, let's go to the cornerbacks. Not sure why that came out like that, but anyway, Talib, he's a beast, man. You guys know that he's one of my favorite corners to play with on Madden, period. You guys know that. So when I caught him for like 10 or 11K, something crazy like that, I hopped on it, man. The Deion Sanders, you get it with the freeze promo. This card is an absolute beast. This is one game in my next season. The next season I'm going to show you where he just plays amazing. I mean, you guys are going to be like, golly, man. I didn't think that card was like that. So if you're balling on a budget like me and you need a decent corner, man, I know some of you guys don't like playing with these cards because you can't keep them, but insert this card, man. This card is... you won't regret it. Trust me, man. Insert this card. Sean Smith. He's my third corner. Let me make that statement. Now, I played on the last four games. He hasn't done anything to stand out to where I can give you a description version of why you should get him or, you know, what he does. He just hasn't really done anything. I guess people don't throw to the slot receivers a lot. So, in these games that I've played. So I guess that's why I really don't have much to say. I know I had him, Prince Amukamara, I know I had him as my third cornerback for a while. I'm not sure why he's not my fourth, but I'm probably going to change that and make that adjustment. And though I do like Rose, I don't know what it is, but this Rose plays well, though. I'm not really sure what it is, but he plays very well. I might just keep him in there. See what else we got here. Show me what you got. All right, last but not least, I believe. I don't think I'm missing anything. Defensive line. This defensive line is not bad. It's really not bad. Not horrible. Not bad. This guy is clearly the weakest link. Fowler, the reason why he's not the weakest link, because even though he has the lowest overall, he's fast, he's athletic, and he has just enough awareness to pick up on turnovers and stuff like that. He does a good job of having a knack of feeling, finding the ball when the ball is fumbled. I'm not sure what it is, but he has a great knack for that. And he's young and quick, his 75 overall doesn't do him justice. You know, he's probably but he plays like an 82 overall. This is the best card on my defensive line, bar none. He gets the most sacks. He causes the most havoc. He just gets in there. It's an 85 overall card, practically an elite card. He just finds a way to get in there, and he causes havoc, and he's just a nightmare for a lot of opponents you guys will see in the videos. Not too much I can say about these guys. You know, there's some run stuffers. You know, past that, you know, that's about it. I've got the punter. You know, kicker. This guy's not a bad kicker. You know, he's 70 overall. Hope I can upgrade that soon. I told you guys about Tavon. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it wasn't too long for you guys. Hopefully I didn't get too descriptive. This is your boy, Launchpad1412. If you guys enjoyed the vid, and I'm out.